Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edin TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through geography form 1, lesson number 19. The topic it is statistical methods. Welcome. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudhoni. Let us look at our lesson goals today. We are going to look at, or by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to understand the concept of statistical data representation. Let's get started. Now, when we are talking about statistical methods, remember we said it is the methods of collecting, recording, analyzing, presenting, and the interpretation of the data. Already we have done the methods of collecting the data, recording the data, we have also analyzed the data, and now we are in data presentation. Data presentation can be done in either one or a two-dimensional drawings that show the relationship between two types of the data. So that is the reason as to why we refer to it as data presentation. We must get the relationship between two variables, two types of the data. When one variable changes, it causes a change in another variable. So this is, for example, when we look at the production of the tea in every year, it keep on changing every year. We don't have the same value or the same quantity being produced this year, and then it is the one that is produced next year. So that one now results into changing in the other variable. The first one is called an independent variable, while the second one is called the dependent variable. Let us look about the difference between the independent variable and the dependent variables. When we talk about the independent variable, its changing does not depend on the other one. For example, when it comes to 1 year, changing from 1 year to another year, it does not require the other commodity to change in order for it to change. But when I talk about the quantity of the commodity being produced, it keep on changing depending on the year we are in. That is the reason as to why it becomes dependent variables. Most of the cases, you get the independent variable, it is usually time, while the dependent variable is the other variable. In drawing a graph, the independent variable, the one that does not depend on another one to change, is put on the x-axis, while the dependent variable is put on the y-axis. In Form 1, we are going to look at two types of graphs, because that is one of the ways that we present the data by use of graphs. So in Form 1, you are going to look at the two types, that is simple line graph and simple bar graph. We start by looking at the first one, which is the simple line graph. When we talk about the simple line graph, it is a one-dimensional diagram that shows the relationship between two variables. It is a useful method for presentation of continuous data. So those data that are continuous, remember we said there are two types of statistical data, continuous data and the discrete data. So for the simple line graph, it is used when presenting continuous data, like temperatures. A simple line graph may be either curved or straight with a sharp, angular turns. So it may be either curved or straight. When we talk about the straight curves, you get that they have a sharp, angular turns. A curved simple graphs are used to present continuous data like the mean monthly temperature, population growth rate, and changes in air pressure. Straight, simple line graphs with sharp angular turns are used to represent data which may have some discontinuity. So that is about the simple line graph. Let's take its construction. When we talk about the construction of line graph, you are required to draw the x and the y axis in graph paper. So that is the first step. Step number two, choose a suitable scale for the variables, noting the x axis for the dependent one. Then plot the values accurately using small, faint, but visible dots. Finally, you are supposed to join the faint dots by a smooth curve as shown below. Let us take this example. You have the data that is provided there, and then you are required to draw the graph, which is a simple graph. We have the production in tons. This is the production of tea in tons. 2009 it is 60, 2010 it is 50, 2011 it is 75, 2012 it is 50, 2013 it is 70, and 2014 is 55, and then 2015 70, and 2020 it is 50. So you are required to do that. That is 2016 and not 2020. So when it comes to drawing the graph, you are required, remember you have said you first of all draw the x and the y axis. After that you get the scale. For example, you can be able to see our independent variable, which is the year, is on the x axis. While the dependent variable, which is the potatoes production, is on the y axis. So we get the scales. For the x-axis, it is every year. We take every year, starting from 2009 and ending to 2016. While for the potatoes, because we take the least and the highest, which is the least it is 50 and the highest is 70. So we take a scale that is going to give us all of them. So you can be able to see. Then the next one, it is plotting the point. We just plot them the way you can be able to see. We have plotted them. Finally, you have joined by use of a ruler, where now you have a sharp, angular curve. You can also see that how the line graph can be drawn when it comes to joining by a smooth curve. That is the way it's supposed to be joined. Now, let us look at the advantages of using simple line graphs. It is easy to construct and interpret. Number two, it is easy to read since it shows the trend. Number three, it enables easy comparisons of variation in the associations between two variables. Number four, it does not involve lengthy and tedious calculation. You just plot what is it. Then number five, the trend of the relationship can be easily be seen. Then exact values can be estimated. Disadvantages. It causes of the illustrated relationship cannot be established from the graph. For example, whatever that resulted from the change of the production of the potatoes from the year 2009 to 2010, we are not given unless we get it from other cases. So we don't know what caused that change. It shows no comparisons between two or more sets of the data. So when now we want to give two or more sets of the data, we don't give it in this only one line graph. Does not give a clear visual impression on the quantity of the data. So you don't get that instant grasping of the information. And number four, it ignores some details of change. It may give a false impression on the continuity of some detail. Now let us go to the activity. construction of a simple line graph, you see a curved line. So that is, you are required to draw a simple line graph from the data. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 1, Third Edition.